Guys, I'll make no secret of one fact. For the majority of the last 20 years that I've lived, I've spent quite a bit of it in poverty, right? Relative poverty. I say relative because I know there's always people in the world that have it worse, and I'm not really complaining. I think it's some context to what I'm about to say. I understand how horrible it is to be broke, not have spare cash, and feel trapped. You know, slightly earlier today, I've just been filming a video around one fact, and the fact was, I think that for most people, having more money will get rid of the vast majority of their problems. And people may not like that, but I do believe it to be the case. If you actually have a good think about this, I do believe it to be true. And what I mean by that is, for a lot of people, it's their financial worries that play on their mind the most. Now, if that's the case, it means being broke and having no meaningful way of getting out of it is going to cause people a lot of stress. I did start the video off explaining my situation for a reason, to explain the fact that I understand it's not a nice feeling at all. With that being almost an outright fact, how do we go about freeing ourselves from it? Because it can be a very difficult thing. I think I make the point quite a lot, and I like to keep it the case. The videos that I make are based on real experiences that I've lived and seen, and my opinions based off of that kind of subsequently. Now, in relation to this one, I think it was inspired by a conversation that I was having just a couple days ago with a friend who's a couple years older than me. And the chat was, I'm trapped in a bad job. A job that doesn't pay very much. A job that works long hours and does not fulfill the soul. Now, obviously not every job will. It's quite a difficult thing to find all of those characteristics. But, like I say, I think you should only sacrifice one or two. What I mean by that is, if the conditions are bad, the pay should be good. If the pay's bad, the conditions should be good, and the like. Now, it's easier said than done to find that medium. But, outlining a set of parameters will help us to free ourselves from these difficult positions. Just a suggestion, but I think step one is, think about what your ideal life is, what that looks like, and then process how much it takes to afford that. Then maybe think about how far off you are from that right now, and what changes are needed to make that difference. I think probably the biggest mistake I see people make is assuming that they can save themselves out of the mess, as in financially save up till the problem's complete. For most people, that's not going to be true. Just think about the numbers, right? If you earn, I don't know, £5,000, let's say, a year, let's just say, for example, that's the maximum you can save. So it doesn't matter if you can stack away 100% of your salary, it's not getting yourself out of the hole. I would say a good amount at a time. Half of the solution is to earn more. People focus on saving, like I say. You can't save yourself rich. Whether it's building another income stream, or, I don't know, something else. Maybe getting a more high-skilled and subsequently high-paying job. I guess what I'm saying is, step one is make the realization that you can't save yourself, as in save up, to getting free. But even though I just said that, I think it's highly recommended that everyone who finds themselves in a broke position does try and save up as much as they can. It may be at this point people might think, well, what are you talking about? You just said you can't save yourself rich. You can't. But there's one thing about being poor and being broke and not knowing where the money to pay the next bills and stuff like that. There's one thing about being in that position. You will not have any choice. You will find yourself in a bad position, and that often leads to people making bigger mistakes, I think. Or at least that's what I've seen quite a lot of the time. You know, it seems desperate people do desperate things. And if you're in a position where you're always in need of, well, enough money to even pay the bills and you haven't got it, you are going to make rash and, quite frankly, bad decisions. The way out of that part is to save up some money. I know, I'm not saying an awful lot, but enough to give yourself some thought time. At the minute, most people don't have that. If you're working paycheck to paycheck, you can't slow down. You'll always be in the trap. Step one is to save. It's not going to make you rich, but it is going to give you some time to think about what it is that you truly want. Maybe reflect on the income figures that you need to hit. It's impossible to say what that figure or what that amount is for everybody, but what I see with a lot of people is they either don't want to or can't take any financial risks, as in building a new business or maybe even slowing down life a bit to think, because they can't afford to. The bills are owed, the rent's due, and it just makes it very, very unaffordable to take some time. So that's what I'd personally say is step one. Try get that money to think. Create that breathing room and see what happens from there. And then from there, you'll get a bit of a picture as to what you truly think. I think, at least here in the UK, for example, right, that's a place that I know, people are... they're forced into this sort of lifestyle. It's what's pushed on us basically from school to college to university. It's get a job, work hard, but realistically, for most people, it doesn't warrant them the life that they want. Having the choice to think, having the choice to try new things, gives you the choice to experiment, right? I think it's about acknowledging step one. Step one is this: if what you're doing now isn't working, doing it more is not going to work. It's just going to create the same mess, if not worse. So stop doing that. Think about something new, right? And understand, like I say, your salary, the amount that you make, is always going to be that amount. You're not going to be able to... you can invest it, but then that's kind of creating new income, isn't it? But you're not going to be able to save your way, just alone saving, to gain rich. I am aware that all of these concepts have basically been exhausted, right? You know, rich people make their money work for them, and poor people work for their money. But it is true, right? You can only get so much if your salary is so much. You need to find another source of income. It does take a bit of education and a bit of distinguishing yourself from the crowd, but it is long-term worth it. I have my own page where I talk about reselling. If you want to learn how to resell and dropship on eBay, you can click on the link down below. But what I am going to say is this, right? It took me a while to do this. I've tried numerous different businesses. Although it is painful to be in a position where you don't have money, it's taken me years to get to a position where I have got at least, not a lot, right? Not an amazing amount, but enough to live on. I now have a pretty comfortable life, right? It's a weekday. I'm just out here chilling in the countryside. It's pretty nice. I haven't been to work today, so that's always a plus, because I don't have a job, because I make money online. But from my friends that I see, and they work hours and hours and hours and hours every day, all week, they can't get out. But it's because the system's not built to help you. I know it's a bit of a cliche at this point, but you've got to find a way to escape the matrix. It is going to be difficult, but what's a real difficult choice? I've made the reference several times, but in my eyes, there's two choices. One choice is to take the risk and try, see how things go. And the other is to never have tried. But if you never try, you'll never know. You might have been really successful. You might have had the opportunity to build an amazing business. You might have had the opportunity to go and live the life that you want. The system's not set up in a way that encourages that. Most people are used as units of labour, right? Big companies don't care. And the markets don't tell you how to get yourself out of this position. Because it's in their best interest to have you in that position. The more you work, the more you need to work, the better it is for businesses. They profit, they take the profits, and they're happy with it. Of course they are. Of course they would be. You would be. And like I say, it's going to be different things for everybody, but step one is to have a think about what it could be for you. We live in a difficult time, but we also live in a time that's unlike any other. The same is true for every single generation, but it seems to be in the world of money making and work, our generation haven't fully realised this. We're not in a time anymore where you just go to work, come home, and you can have a really nice life. That's going to be unaffordable for most people. If you're broke, living paycheck to paycheck, don't have any money, find a way, whether it's get a job and work hard for a year, or whether it's, maybe pick up a bit of overtime, or maybe it's just cut down your spending. Find a way to save up a bit of money first. From there, you'll have some breathing time to think about what sort of lifestyle you do truly want, how much it's going to cost to afford that, and from there, what you need to do to make that happen. If you've got the extra cash, you'll be able to take the risk, and you'll feel less bad about it if it goes wrong. But this is what I'd say to the people my age, and maybe around my age, right? Number one is you have no real threat of failure. It's basically impossible. You might not make a profit, you might make a loss, but think about this, right? If you're my age and maybe younger, maybe older, I don't know, your actual dependencies, as in the things that you need to pay off, is probably quite low. You might have a small rent to pay because you're not going to live in a nice place. You might have a cheap car, and you might have a phone. Everybody's circumstances are going to vary, so what your life looks like, I don't know. But you get what I'm saying overall, right? We do not have that much to risk. And yet I see so many people my age, above, slightly below, whatever. They work in every day of the week, and it seems like they're in a dead-end position. At what, 16, 18, 20, 25? What for? You don't have to be there. If you're living at home with friends, whatever, you've got reduced costs of living basically, use them, utilize them. Maybe stop going out and wasting all your money on the weekends. Maybe find a way to save more. Whatever that looks like, maybe it's earning more, maybe it's saving more and spending less. But that will give you the opportunity to think and reflect. Step one is getting yourself into a position where you can think clearly, and that does unfortunately come with having more money. You need to get more money first. Then from there you can think about building up your income. You can have a little bit of capital to risk and not be too mad about losing it. You're obviously going to feel it, but my point is, whether it's keeping up with your cost of living, whether it's investing in a new business or whatever, you're going to need some money to live on and to think. You're going to need some breathing room to feel okay. That's what you need. Once you can create that, you can think a bit more concisely, unlike how I've kind of explained things in this video. I know it was a little bit long, and perhaps I did repeat myself a few times, but I hope it was still of some use to you. If you did find some value, please do leave a like and subscribe. That's what I'd say on this matter. It's a very horrible position to be in, to have no money. But once you get yourself out of it, you start to open the door. Once you've made your first £1,000, whether it's online or some sort of a business, you'll be thinking, oh, that was quite easy. Then it becomes very easy to do 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,000. And that is how you start to build that freedom. I don't know what business model it's going to be. Again, if you want to learn about reselling and dropshipping, link is down below. But you need to think about something, right? Different times, different solutions. We don't live in the 1950s anymore. We need to work differently, but most people don't seem to account for this. Anyway, I think it's about time that I head home. Thank you for watching this video. If you did enjoy it, of course, don't forget to give it a like and smash that subscribe button too. I would appreciate it. But for this one, that's basically all I had to say. So I'll leave you with some nice countryside shots, I suppose, and I guess that's really it. Thank you. Goodbye.